Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, parang program. Okay, so welcome to our class. This is RT224, Imaging Equipment and Maintenance. So as a trend, since we are on online platform, so we need to check first your attendance to see that if you are really there. And of course, this attendance can be given points, diba? Redemption point na tinatawag. Ah, kung leto term, may redemption point for the next chapter exam. So for this afternoon, atong chapter exam, iuduhala muna nga attendance. Okay, malulugi na. 15 na daw ito kung ako naigaan. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, can you please open your camera? Huwag na kayong mahiya. Alam ko naman ang papangit niyo dati pa. Kasi ako lang naman talaga dito yung kailangan pinaka-good-looking. Wow! Okay, so yun, hindi camera dapat naka-ano, hindi rin kayo agtang dati ipapakita. Kaya sunod, agtang latak may kilala iyo, bahala kang. Okay, yun. So ang ganda ng ating Google Meet, oh, di ba, naka-open tanan ang camera. So, meaning mga taga Section A, wow, mga ano, photogenic, oh, di ba, mga photo and telegenic. Okay, sige, smile, 1, 2, 3, MA, ayun, so yan, so, okay, kailangan naman din ipasa for our monitoring. Oh, dari kami nagpi-picture-picture la for the sake of, ano, of photography session. We need to submit this one for our monitoring kay Ben makasugad nga sa Ronjel dere nagkla-class nagbe-mekos-mekos lang. Actually ginano ko gihapon yung record ko gihapon classic. Ay again, this is for the monitoring ng college. Ayun. So I'm going to update you with the attendance later. Ang ganda ng smile ni Miss Ortego. Sana all inspired. Okay, so let's come to our discussion for this afternoon. Okay, this is a continuation of last week's discussion, tama ba? So, nakulangan kita ng oras last week, kaya iko-continue na ito. Actually, gusto ko ganin siya. Sabi ko nga niya kanina Section B, gusto ko talaga ini siya face-to-face. Pero anan ko man last week, manang. Mga manangan mano. Di ko na tumakaya. Alauna na kami maagahon natapos ang canvassing. Kinin-madextros. Kahumanhit kuan. Kahumanhit ako ng klase 9A. Ang pamati ko ma-admit na kadto hospital. Hinatatapos. May da pa ako practical exam para mga incoming fourth year students. Kaya talaga makakaya ng katawang lupa ko. Kaya, I thought di rin kita makakag-online yan na. So ayun, na-suspend na naman because of the high heat index na talagang pumapalo siya sa 42 degrees Celsius. But anyway, all of us naman somehow on the bright side, naka-benefit naman kita na kaya dila kita atong mga balay. Labi na ako. Dila kami tambalay. Kahirayo ako. Palo late pa ako. So ang dami ko nang pinagsasabi. Nami ko nang pinagsasabi, wala naman kayong pakialam, Chor. So, we discussed about the X-ray tube. So, we define X-ray tube, its purpose, the primary parts. And then we talk about the different support system, the ceiling support system, the floor to ceiling support system, the C-arm support system. Then we discussed the external components of the X-ray tube. Ayun, the protective housing, the collimator of the positive beam limiting device, the glass envelope, as well as the metal enclosure. Likewise, we talk about filtration. Sabi natin, this is beam hardening. Yung iba, part ng X-ray tube, especially the inherent plus the added filtration. But may mga tinatawag tayong tissue compensating filters na hindi naman part ng X-ray machine. But nilalagay ito as well as for beam hardening. No? Okay, so we also discuss different components of the X-ray tube. So nandun yung cathode, una sa cathode, the negative side of the X-ray tube, So, nandun sa filament at saka si focusing cap. So, for the anode naman, we defined or we give the two parts, two types of anode. We have stationary and rotating anode. So, we gave the different parts. We have the target. Okay, the anode layering that we call. And then we have the focal spot. We also discussed the line focus principle and extension of the line focus principle. Kaya meron na tayo sa radiology tinatawag na anode hill effect. We need to determine asan yung direction ng cathode, asan direction ng anode during radiography. And we start with the off-focus radiation. So, ang haba-haba naman ano. Don't you worry, class. Later with the chapter exam, hindi kayo maboboard. Yeah, I'm going to make sure that hindi kayo maboboard. Hindi, masagot yung mga, ay, katsaka-tsaka naman yung mga question ni sir. Pang ano man lang ini, pang elementary, very basic. That's why I don't need to read book. Later, may dan. Medyo tinamad kasi ako, guys. Kasi kahapon, medyo na-busy ako kahapon. Wow. Na-busy kahapon. So, kagabi, tinatamad ako. Wari man ako ka-late night talk. Okay, at mga ka-late night talk na ako, yan ko convert ko nalang ito paghimo nalang mga test paper, mga test question. Kaya tinatamad ako kagabi, you know. So, ano akong lanahimo, 70 items lang para iyo chapter test yan na good for 1 hour. So, kaya sabi ko, hindi rin ka mabuboard yan na 4-hour chapter exam. So, ayun. Ano? Okay, so let's continue. Sabi ko nga, mas mapainta kung face-to-face yun kay kinukurayan na pag-determine. Kanina nga nina aga, my God, it was quite a challenge. Magpaparecite ako, pero unending, ako lang yung gihapon and mag-identify kung asan dyan, bakit ganun, bakit ganito. So we have X-ray tube failure, that discussion. So para mapugan nato ng X-ray tube failure, so we need to make a long-term solution, kumbaga. Kaya nga, di ba, diyan, na-emphasize natin, sang untaan, skulahan, may da tinatawag na long-term solution para hindi nga heat index kay makurinin online la, di pa, online classes. Kaya iba, sir, eme, waray ako nag-keme, waray nakapsulod, keme, di ba? Unta, may long-term solution natin. Like, for example, air condition, kasi we talk about heat. Sa X-ray tube kasi, may that's the time na talagang wakayin imo X-ray tube, di ba? X-ray tube is the heart of the X-ray machine. So, we need to secure, okay, that diri siya magkakamayadahin tube failure. So, tube failure has several causes, but most of which are related to thermal characteristics. It's related to heat. Pero yan na, may heat index, mainit. So, kaya makita nyo guys, lahat ng mga X-ray department ng naka air conditioned, no? This is for the security, not only for the personnel. Kailangan iprotektahan man lahat naton ng aton X-ray tube. So this heat can be dissipated in one of the three ways. So nagkakamayad ang heat because of radiation in a way, and scientific nga definition niya, because this is the transfer of heat emission of infrared radiation. So because of conduction, this is the transfer of energy from one area of an object to another. And via convection, this is the transfer of heat by movement of heated substance from one place to another. So these are the instances kay ano nagkakamayadahin high heat. Ayan, in hataas nga paso, di ba? Remember? The projectile electron, out of the 100% projectile electron, 99% of which are converted to heat, only 1% is converted to X-ray. So damuan na produce ng heat. No? Okay, so a second type of X-ray tube failure results from maintaining the prolonged at elevated temperatures for prolonged periods. So maiha ang pagginamit, no? So, during exposures lasting to 1 to 3 seconds, the temperature of the anode may be sufficient to cause it to glow like incandescent light bulb. Temperature pa din, elevated temperature, heat pa din yung pinag-uusapan natin. A final cause of high tube failure involves the filament. high temperature again of the filament. So tungsten atoms are vaporized slowly and the plate plate the inside of the glass or metal enclosure with normal. And the most frequent cause of abrupt tube failure is arcing. Research. What is arcing? Kasi daw, sabi dito, pag nag-vaporize ang mga filament, an era na hinabo, nakukoat niya ang, okay, nakukoat niya ang mga enclosure. Okay, hindi lang, may napasok sa ating Google Meet. Okay, so for the long-term solution of the X-ray tube failure, para mabawasan natin ini nga problema when it comes to heat, so may da tayo mga remedies for this. So three types of X-ray tube rating charts are particularly important. So we have the radiographic rating chart, we have the anode cooling chart, and we have the housing cooling chart. So nakikita natin, parehas manlihera cooling. So in a way, may pagkasimilarity ano. Okay, radiographic rating chart, anode cooling, and housing cooling chart. So ito yung mga kailangan nating malaman dito. Paano masasabi nating safe, paano masasabi nating unsafe for that. So we have the radiographic rating chart. Okay, so I would like just to clarify with you guys that they're in generic, ha? It doesn't mean na lahat ng radiographic rating chart, yan ito yung appearance. So each machine, manufacturer has their own radiographic rating chart. So ini makikita ini niyo when you purchase yung ano ba, yung when you purchase your X-ray machine, mayroon tayo tinatawag na manual, user's manual. Diba? I guess you are familiar with that one. Pag mag-value ka mong bagong cellphone, may need to manual ang paggamit. Bagong ref. So everything na mga bagong appliances, bagong gadget, may manual natin. So ini nga radiographic rating chart, makikita ini natin dito aton kanan machine, manualan machine, no. So the x-axis and the y-axis shows the scales of two parameters, the time and KVP. So as for the x-axis, ayun, may kita natin dito, KVP. So for this one, kita natin apat yung chart dito, ano? So we have 1, we have 2, ayun, 3, parang binibinaw, and we have the fourth one. So, yun, depende iyo machine. Okay, so we have again for parameters, time and KVP. So kita natin dito KVP. Adiliwat, exposure time sa y-axis. Sa exposure time. So for x-axis, si KVP, si y-axis, puro siya exposure time. Dali lang, tanggalon ko lahat, i-discard ko. Yan. Okay, so for a given MA, so any combination, what's the fuss? Why are you messaging me? So for any combination of, what's the name? Dali lang, ha? What's this one? Okay. Dali lang, ha? Okay, anyway, so For a given MA, any combination of KVP and time that lies below the MA curve is safe. So again, kung makita natin an x-axis, KVP siya, no? Kapres itong tanan. And y-axis, puro siya exposure time. So kung makita natin, ini nga mga nakagraph nga da, mga MA. So for example, this one, nakalabel siya nga da, 100 MA, 150 MA for this line, 200 MA for this line, yon. So bago didi, for a given MA, any combination of time that lies below the MA curve is safe. So for example, this one, let's say, nakabutang dito ang technique, ano mo technique factor is, let's say, surat ko na laha, surat ko na lang iyo ano ha iyo in call messages. So may nakabutang dito nga for example 75 KVP. What else? 150 MA. One second. Point 6 millimeter FS, tapos 3,400 RPM. So, paano natin masusugad niya, safe or unsafe? So 75 kVp, 150 MA, 1 second, 0.6 millimeter FS, 3,400. Okay. So 3,400. So any guys, we need to check the medyo nasasamok ako kay may daano nagme-message ako ng taga hospital kadali la pinas may daw kasi intern nga nagpipinasaway dali la LG. Medyo na nadidistract ako may nagpipinasaway ka intern pasensya la naka-record pagod ako. Okay. Wala din na appear di ko naka-share na akong Facebook. Okay, so paano natin nasusugat nga safe or unsafe? So first and foremost, we need to check. Eh bayan ka magano, babayan ka mo pag I don't know. Bangin niyan pag masud ka mo hay nga graph tak gagamiton. So kailangan may himuon muna naton. Okay, ko may kita niyo in iton aton pinaka inside nga box yan. So may mga indications naton didi ha. So nakabutang di da 3,400 RPM, adi single phase, tapos adi an focus path size 0.6 millimeter. Like for this one, so 10,000 RPM, tapos adi 3 phase, tapos 0.6 millimeter focal spot. For this one, 3,400 RPM, single phase, 1 millimeter focal spot. So kailangan ano naton dida. Okay, for example, anaton gin message dida aton GC or aton in call message. So nakabutang ako dida 75 kVp. Tapos 75 kVp. Tapos na nakabutang 1 second. Tapos pera nak MA 150 MA. So bago didi for a given MA, any combination of KVP and time that lies below the MA curve is safe. So kikitaon natin ang curvature ni 150 MA. Kailangan para masugad natin nga safe, ang combination ni KVP ngayon ni time kailangan below sa MA. So 175, dito siya no, and then dito si 1. So ang kanra intersection is this one. So meaning this is below the 150 MA. So therefore, 75 kVp, 1 second, 150 mA, 3,400 RPM, 0.6 millimeter focal spot is a safe radiographic technique. Yan. So any combination of kVp and time that lies above the curve representing the desired MA is unsafe. Like for example, masugad kita 100 ganun din. So, let's say ito. So, ganun na ako ng example. 100 kVp. Ano pa? 150 mA. 1 second. 3,400 RPM. Tapos, 0.6 millimeter FS. So, kung igpaplatinin natin siya, 100 kVp, 150 mA, 1 second, 3,400 RPM, 0.6 millimeter focal spot size. Okay, so, look at here, we are also using the same, the same graph. So, igplat natin, see, 100 kVp, 1 second, tapos, tama ba, 150 na kabutang, 150 mA. Keep. Okay. 150 mA. Yan. 150 mA. Kaya nga ni gusto ko ini mag face to face. So, 150 mA. So, kita ang tat era intersection. So, 100. Tapos, unone. So, this is above the curvature of the above the curvature of 150 mA. So, meaning this is not safe. No? So, any combination of kVp and time that lies above the curve representing the desired MA is unsafe. So, again, para maray makakuha, if ever the combination of kVp and time is below the desired the indicated MA, so this is safe. So if the combination of kVp and time is above the indicated MA, this is unsafe. Ano? So, yun, that's it. Okay, so let's answer this one. Hala, sorry. Ano ha, kadali la papa, dituyon ko lang ha. Dituyon ko lang ang mga numeric values. Can I use 12? Ah, no. 14. Laro na ito nero. Tapos pa dako ang kuwading ha. Graph. Can I? Pwede pa pala. Okay, so let's, you answer this one in 5 minutes. So you write your answer in our in-call messages. Butan rin to letter A, kung safe or not safe. Letter B.
Excuse me po, sir. Tanan po ito, sir.
Yes, letter A, B, C, D, E. Lima lang ito. So, you write letter A. Mabutang ka mo dito. Safe. Letter B, unsafe. Natulungan. Okay, may napasok po. Yeah. Ayun, may naka-answer, may nag-answer na. Safe and safe, 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 and safe, and safe, 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 safe. Iskili ang sadi. Okay, sige. Kita ko yung mga answers. How about the others? Matutulog lang ba kayo? Magpapa-attendance na ba kamo? Okay, sige. So, let's check this one. Kasi kanina na medyo mahulagyapot na yung ending. Gusto ko ipa-recite sa students, pero ako lagi hapon na nagte-trace. So pakikita na lang ha, just fix your gaze at the virtual screen. Charet. So let's check letter A. Kung tama ba niyo answer. So let's plot this one. Una natin, we need to identify first kay para mas madali mahanap, 3,400 RPM and 0.6. So we will use this chart here. Okay, now let's plot this one. Hanapon natin si 150 MA. Okay. So 95 and 1 second, so more or less nandito si 95, tapos nandito si 1 second. Okay. So if we're going to intersect this one, so nandito siya. This is above the one, the curvature of 150 MA. So imbutan ko lang nga x kung unsafe, x check kung safe, unsafe for x for unsafe. So this is unsafe. Okay, very good. For those who get the correct answer, maka-identify na. May nag-message? Did I get a message? Ah, ito na. Okay. Sige. Letter B. So let's plot this one, letter B. So we need first to identify the RPM. Doon naman ini ako. RPM is 3,400 and 1 millimeter focal spot. So we will use this chart, this one. So hanapon natin with 400 MA. So we plot 85 kVp. So more or less nandito siya. And then si 0.5 second. So nandito siya. So the intersection, sorry, is nandito siya sa taas. So meaning letter B is also not safe for use.
Okay.
Sorry. So letter A unsafe, letter B unsafe, letter C. Okay, so okay, 1 millimeter focal spot size and then 10,000 RPM. 1 millimeter focal spot size. That's okay, we need to use this one. Okay, so hanapin natin 125 kVp. Yun. Tapos 0.1 second. Ito. So nandito yung kanilang intersection. Ilan yung MA? 500. So letter C is safe. Okay, letter D. 0.3, 10,000 RPM, 1 millimeter focal spot, same na graph. So we need to find 700 MA. Andito siya. Okay. Tapos 75 kbp, 0.3 second. Nag-una na siya. So nandito. So letter D is also safe. Letter E, 88 kVp, 400 MA, 0.1 second, 10,000 RPM, 0.6 ade. So we'll use this one. Okay, so 88. So mostly nandito siya in between 75 at saka 100. Okay, so yung hinahanap natin, I mean yung reference natin si 400 MA. So if we're going to plot 88 at saka 0.1, okay, narin naman inin. So nandito siya sa taas ni 400. So letter E is unsafe for use in, okay, in operation. Yun. So did you get the correct answers? Tingnan nga natin. Discard ko lang muna. Did you get the correct answers? Tingnan ko nga. Juliana Ortego, wala siyang idea kanina. Letter A lang iya ginsurat. Baman, unsafe, safe. Okay, very good. Kapukyan, letter A lang. Kuna, mali. Okay, mali lahat. at least dire papuntos, ware papuntos ano. So now you know you need to know how to get the safe and unsafe. Relox, wala pa rin siyang idea. I don't know. Sapa. Okay. 1, 2. Majority mali. Kapukyan. Safe. Na may mga mali. Okay. Spinya. Okay. Nakakuha na. Disolok. Okay. So, as I've said, hindi kayo mabuboard mamaya for chapter test. Kasi meron yan. Okay, so I hope walang questions about this one. So nakuha na how to identify the safe. Again, let me clarify. The radiographic rating chart is available sa inyong mga radiographic unit manual. Ano, hindi siya standardized. Yung ginagamit natin is from GE or from General Electronics ng machine. Okay. Naman not available sa internet. Okay, sige. If there are no questions, so sige, let me proceed. We proceed with the next one. Anyway, I promise, I promise that madali na lang eh. Mga, tapos ko na. Pero naman lang ang slide. 1, 2, 3. 3 na lang o 3? Okay, so next one. So we have the anode cooling chart. So for the anode cooling chart in X-ray operations, so thermal energy or heat energy is measured in heat units or joules. So one heat unit is equal to the product of so KVP, MA, and exposure time. And one heat unit is also equal to 1.4 joules. So calories and British thermal units, BTUs, and other familiar thermal units. So the thermal capacity of an anode and its heat dissipation characteristics are contained in a rating chart called an anode cooling chart. So this one, kita itong magmamanual finding. We will look for the manual. So for you need to identify anot iyo X-ray machine, anot iya generator. So makita natin ini nga symbol, ano ni sigma, adire ni sigma. Okay, so this is phase. So single phase, this one. This is three phase, six pulse. Okay, so we have three phase, 12 pulse. And we have the high frequency generator. So ikaw mismo nga Radtech, you need to know anot imo unit, anot generator it imo X-ray machine. Is it single phase, three phase 6 pulse, three phase 12 pulse, or high frequency? But for the purpose of our examinations, for mga problem solving, you don't need to worry kasi naka-indicate man talaga dito using a single phase generator, using a three phase 12 pulse, so naka-indicate dito a problem. All you need to know is kailangan you need to memorize their generator factor. So for single phase, adit iya generator factor 1. Di ba nakita kami niya formula? KVP times MA times time times generator factor. Okay. So for three phase 6 pulse 1.35, for three phase 12 pulse 1.41, and for high frequency it's 1.45. Okay, so again the formula, heat units KVP times MA times time times generator factor. So ang magiging product niya kailangan ang imo unit is in terms of joules, ha? Paray na iba, joules. So, halimbawa, 5,000 ang iya heat unit. So, 5,000 what? 5,000 joules. Okay. So, let's take this problem. Answer this one in 3 minutes. How much heat energy in joules is produced during a single high frequency radiographic exposure of 25 kVp and 200? Ay, para di ka malipat. Okay, naka MAS, sige. 200 MA and 1 second. Sige, 3 minutes. High frequency, 1.45. Do not use the pre-significant figures 1.45 kasi 1.41 is for three-phase 12 pulse. So 25 kVp times 200 times 1.45, supposedly 1.45. Check niyo, so check. Okay, so how much heat energy in joules is produced during a single high-frequency mammographic examination of 25 kVp, 200 mA, and 1 second? So, okay, let us check your answers. Yan. Okay, yan. Okay nila na-edit na yun. 7,250 joules. Okay, very good. Okay, so again, you need to use the, ano, the factor itself na. For single phase, bisan din naman kailangan siguro i-multiply by 1, di ba? Automatic naman yan. So you need to use for three-phase 6 pulse, 1.35. For three-phase 12 pulse, 1.41. For high frequency, that is 1.45. Okay, sine. Okay, very good. So 7,250 joules. Okay, so wala ba tayong questions dito? Wala, 1.15 na. Tapos ang exam ano, mag-close siya 3 p.m. Okay, sige, let's move further. Kung walang questions, but anyway, if you have question, you may interrupt me all the time. Agad-agad, so that we can make this a more interactive one. Okay, so for housing cooling chart, and we don't, the cooling chart for the housing of the X-ray tube has a shape similar to that of the anode cooling chart and is used in precisely the same way. So, ganyan din, mag-ano din kayo, mag-solve. Ito yung formula din. Anode cooling and housing cooling chart. So, kung napansin niyo, ano, ayun, kukompute natin ang mga joules. So, makompute nga nini natin. So, magpapalit kita ng aircon, which is equivalent, ano, how many joules and mga, ano, na, para makompensate natin and heat nga napoproduce ni X-ray tube, makompensate niya with the use of aircon. Sana, all naka-aircon. Okay, so that's it. Yun lang. That's our class. I was expecting na face to face kasi nga medyo makurya ako nga adya ka kaluyong sa kabilang mundo. So, do you have any questions, guys? If wala, then let's proceed. Ano, are you ready for the chapter test? Diretso na lang kamo pag-pray nga da iyo balay. Ano? So, I need to, kailangan i-kuang ko na siya, i-send ko na para at least, ano, matapos ka mo within the expected time. Okay. Sige, so, what are the questions? So, stop share ko muna. And then, I will need to stop recording kay maghatag na ako hin link for the chapter test. So good luck everyone. So your time is until 3 p.m. Okay, of course this afternoon. So stop recording. So